Hello, welcome to the Data Converters Application Questionnaire Series. When working with all TI products, it is important to reference the product data sheet, which can be found in the product folder on TI.com. For more troubleshooting information, please refer to TI.com/troubleshooting. In today's training, we will discuss the analog input signals in the Data Converters Application Questionnaire. Before we begin, it's important to know that TI has additional training materials on TI.com. These courses include TI Precision Labs regarding AC and DC specifications, offset and gain calibration, total noise calculation, and voltage reference, as well as TI's analog engineer's pocket reference. In addition, TI has free simulation software called Tina TI that can also be used as a resource for further DC, transient, and frequency domain analysis that can be downloaded at ti.com/tina-ti. In this video, we will be reviewing the effective documentation that will help drive TI's investigation to potential root cause in an analog signal chain. In the analog input signal section, TI requests for customers to provide the input source information, such as reference voltage, frequency, and amplitude range. It is suggested to provide values using an oscilloscope instead of a digital multimeter when possible. We will be showing a live demonstration using the ADS-1299 EVM, oscilloscope, and waveform generator. The waveform generator will be providing a 2 kHz AC input signal with an amplitude of roughly 312 millivolts. Next, we will measure the reference voltage of the ADC. For the ADC reference voltage, channel 2 is observing roughly 2 volts. It is important to capture oscilloscope images for all relevant data shown here in order to effectively debug reported issues. In this analog signal chain example, we have an AC source, RC filters, buffer, ADC, and microcontroller. The expected input voltage range to the system and the expected input range to the ADC input are required values to debug customer returns. Let's review a couple of key points. Submitting all analog input signals will help expedite TI's investigation and increase the probability of finding the root cause on the reported issue. In addition, it is encouraged to debug power supplies, analog signal chain, and digital communication in an ADC system. Thank you for watching this troubleshooting series on analog input signals. For additional troubleshooting information, please visit ti.com/troubleshooting.